the decision by the International Criminal Court to confirm charges against four Kenyans believed to have perpetrated violence during the 2008 post-election violence is seen by Kenyans as a break from the past, where impunity reigned supreme. The move to confirm cases against Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta, Head of Public Service Francis Muthaura, Eldoret North MP William Ruto, and radio journalist Joshua Arap Sang has received the backing of civil society groups, religious leaders, and many Kenyans in the street. The umbrella body for the churches in Kenya, the National Council of Churches of Kenya, NCCK, has termed the move as a rapid step towards the ending the culture of impunity in Kenya. NCCK Secretary General Canon Peter Karanja said that the body appreciates the fact that the pre-trial chamber did not assign guilt or innocence to the suspects and urged Kenyans to maintain peace. According to Asango Chesoni, the Executive Director of Kenya Human Rights Commission, there is need for the government to work out mechanisms of establishing a local tribunal to try lower cadre perpetrators of violence, and calling on President Mwai Kibaki and Prime Minister Raila Odinga to relieve Deputy Prime Minister Uhuru Kenyatta and Head of Public Service Francis Muthaura of their duties. The Director for International Center for Justice, George Kegoro, said that there is need for the government to cooperate with the ICC to save the people of Kenya from international ignominy. And Kenyans have welcomed the idea, turning it justice to the victims of post-election violence. Joel Omondi, for instance, an Eldoret resident, says that in 1992, his father was shot by an arrow in Eldoret as leaders wipe up ethnic emotions. And in 2007, her sister's breasts were chopped off by a gang in Naivasha town. In the online media, petition to lock for 5 million signatures to have leaders facing charges at the ICC step aside from their plumped government positions has been launched to counter the move. Supporters of the accused have also launched the same. Reacting to the ICC ruling on Monday, President Mwai Kibaki called upon Kenyans to maintain peace and directed Attorney General Professor Githu Muigai to form a legal team to advise the government on the way forward. Prime Minister Raila Odinga, who was in a development tour in southern Sudan, also called on Kenyans to put the nation first. Two of the suspects left off the hook, former Police Commissioner Hussein Ali and former Industrialization Minister Henry Kosgei, have welcomed the ICC ruling, saying it has vindicated them against claims of murder, displacement, and rape. The confirmed suspects have indicated that they will lodge an appeal against the decision and that they will cooperate. Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto have maintained that their presidential ambitions are on course, irrespective of the ICC verdict. An argument that has put them at loggerheads with civil society groups who want them to follow the chapter on integrity in the new constitution. This is the first time Kenyans are facing trial at the Hague-based court. The 2008 post-election violence led to the death of about 1,200 Kenyans, 10,000 displacement, rape, and massive destruction of property. On Tuesday, ICC prosecutor Luis Moreno Campos said that he does not intend to appeal against the two whose charges were thrown out. Mr. Campos said he will instead order thorough investigations on them. Reporting for IQ4 News from Eldoret, Kenya, I'm Joab Apollo.